Hi, and welcome to this Spacecraft Dynamics Capstone course. My name is Hans-Peter Schaub, and I'm a professor here at the University of Colorado at Boulder. So at this stage, I'm assuming you've taken the three prior courses on spacecraft kinematics, spacecraft kinetics, and spacecraft control. Kinematics, you learned how to describe orientation. Kinetics, you learned how to predict attitude motions. And then the control, you figured out how to actually make it converge onto a desired attitude. The project that you're doing here is a longer simulation project, which combines elements from kinematics, kinetics, and the control part. The first few stages actually have you define these different orientations that you're going to need to do different missions. The mission we're looking at is a Mars mission with a mother craft that has a smaller daughter craft flying around Mars at the same time. The daughter craft is the one that has science, so you have to figure out, let's say this is a daughter craft, you have to then figure out how the daughter craft can point at the planet to do science. It may have to point certain parts of the craft at the sun to get power, or it may have to point different parts of the craft over and at the mother craft so we can do a data transfer and communicate back and forth. Those are the three attitude modes. Those are pretty realistic modes you will find in any spacecraft mission. Each has different objectives. So as you step through the tasks that you're doing, you will define the different orientations. Those are your references that you have to do. You have to write simulations to propagate the dynamics and predict these motions, and then you apply the control and pick up the gains that you have to do to get certain behaviors. These behaviors are similar to what you have in real life, where somebody might tell you, you've got 2 minutes to do this maneuver to get from sun pointing to science mode and have settled. So you have to pick appropriate gains as specified in the tasks to make that work. The final part then, really, the last task, kind of puts everything together into a fun simulation to where you will have to simulate the spacecraft actually orbiting around Mars, and as it's in the sun, it points at the sun, or it does science, or it does communication, different phases, and it will automatically switch and transition between those. This takes a little bit more programming, but this is a critical task that you often have to do with spacecraft attitude control design, because we can't just build and test something. We have to do everything through simulation and validation. Part of the validation, some of these latter sections also have videos, brief videos that show you the resulting motion that your spacecraft should be doing. This will help you understand the problem statement, but it essentially also gives you a video form of the answers, so you can kind of see, that's how it should be settling. So make use of that. If you wish, you can always make these videos yourself of your motions. That's a great way to visualize and double check your work as well. But with that said, I hope you have fun with this capstone and that you've enjoyed this entire course sequence. Thank you.